So I'm going to make a presentation of the statue of RPM Fusion of this third-part community repository. I'm quite it's quite interesting to make this presentation at this time because, for example, we have some issue with infrastructure currently. So I'm quite pleased to make this presentation now to explain to you what we need as a project and what we expect to fix in the next months or the next Fedora release. I'm not. Maybe I will ask some question about who are using this third-party repository in the room. So maybe others are not using this repository, and people that are not using third-party repository in Fedora. I think that exists also. So maybe some of you know people that doesn't use a third-party repository. No. Everyone is using any third-party repository. So this is a commonly used repository, maybe. But I think there is some people that doesn't use this repository. The fact that we are making this presentation within a Fedora event is quite interesting, and I'm pleased that some of you maybe have chosen this presentation because that's not common that a community repository that is some kind of banned from Fedora can be discussed in the Fedora events, because we often try to not say the name of which community repository can help user in the Fedora mailing list, in the official Fedora mailing list, but we all know to explain other people and user to install this repository as needed. Maybe it's not always needed, but when it's needed, it's very useful to some user. And I'm going to enter into the details about what are the different sections in this repository. This is not the topic, but instead I'm going to to describe of it, to describe the different point of view that might interest the user and the different state of this third-party repository from user perspective and developer perspective. Or contributor perspective, so this is the different topic I will try to address. I just will start with a few words about me. So I'm French. Maybe I should apologize for my accent, my English is not very well, but I'm living in Paris, and I've studied architecture. I'm architecture design in the School of the Beaux-Arts at Paris. So I'm not from computer studies, but I've entered in computers and free software using tools to do rendering and images. So I was interested in this area from my experience with architecture. Maybe something about from something I studied at that time was that when in architecture you have to follow some rule from urbanism, try to obey this rule to get freedom and try to get freedom from certain some kind of rule. And it's something that I try to found in my work and working with package and trying to solve issue with some that need to be solved within a certain kind of rule. So I'm a Fedora package maintainer since 2007. And I'm working for Linagora, a French company, which is doing only free software and open source since 2009. So I'm will speak a little bit of work on Linagora later. Then I'm a coordinator of a third party repository since 2011. And I'm married with Incarnation, which is my wife since 2013. She's in this room. So she's supporting me, and as a consequence, she's supporting the project also. Just a few words about what I've done in Linagora. I'm working in company that is well aware of free software and open source. I've worked in, for example, on the left is a project by JC Deco, who is trying to build a dedicated OS for display image in the airport and some place. And another project with Orange for the desktop of commercial. So from this project, I've tried to play with ARM device and light desktop client. So I'm quite interested in trying to work with ARM light clients from this experience. That's why I try to push that on this third party community repository. And this project on the left was made using Fedora. So, about this third party repository, I've made some stats, a little bit of stats. We will see later. It's a project created in 2008. It was Fedora 8 also. Quite some time passed since then. So it was merged from other community repository or personal repository. And it's still using, like it was using Plaid at that time when Fedora was using Plaid. So Plaid is a build system. I think it's also used by CentOS in Germany. Not sure, but they are using Koji for the external interface with building dedicated spin, and they are using Plaid internally. And the idea is to follow the the Fedora process and the IDE whenever it's possible. We have some kind of one guidelines that is meant to be stay as close as possible as Fedora. But we are actually a different project. One funny thing was that appeared some time ago was when some kind of special interest group made a decision, I think it was the KDU once, that made a special decision that they need to install some kind of library by default in the build route because they want to circumvent some kind of issue they had with GStreamer and VLC. So it was kind of funny that they made this decision in this SIG meeting, and that decision applied to us as a project, as a third-party project. So that was quite funny, but actually we are different projects with different way of making decision. And of course, there is different people involved, so some of them are the same. Some little stats about that. Okay, so as you can read, there is 200 source package in the free section, for 87 in the non-free section. We have been in the primary architecture. ARM is a new primary architecture, starting Fedora. We can say in the Fedora case, it's I think it's Fedora 19 or 20 maybe, and we've made this as premier in Fedora 22 because it's using the same Koji instance that other x84 build. So there is around 5 gigabytes of software for the Fedora 22 release, including debug and all. And there is around 150 packages in the FAS project, and a little bit less in CVS commit. So it means some people using FAS for the project are not only a packager. There's also people involved in the infrastructure and some other. Okay, maybe it's not. As you can see, this is from a daily snapshot of people from the US. So it's one quarter of the circle that are coming from the US. This is statistics taken from the mirror list, the public mirror, the mirror. And because it's actually it's statistic from the mirror manager, and the statistic shows that there is as the same as Fedora, as we have seen this morning, there is quite the same difference between x86 and 64 and x86. That's the same, it's quite the same situation, and ARM is around 1% less than 1%. So this is the same we can see with Fedora. This is the raw statistic taken from Mirror Manager, and we probably don't see the difference, but this is the blue area is Fedora 2022 in June there is 5%, around 5%, and in August there is 15%. So we show the same result as the Fedora infrastructure, so this is quite similar result. So from a user perspective, I was trying to figure out what user are seeing when they use the project. So which is the project, the process they follow to use the project, to install package, and to get a relation with us. So the first step when they use a project is probably to get into the wiki, and what they are thinking is in this kind of infrastructure with the DocuWiki, and this is the front page of the project. So there's quite a lot of area to improve in this, this area, because probably there is some kind of documentation to improve and to get a better front page, or to move the Fedora support release in maybe in first place to get better support. But the principal information for them is probably to get into the wiki and to browse to the user process to install the package. So they are going to install it from a command line or graphical install. But from the user's perspective, the wiki is probably something that is under underused, because they probably don't find information to install their package, or not each package have a wiki page. So what's the method to install one or other package is not addressed in this wiki. So maybe it's addressed in the upstream wiki, but not well the case, and not the part that is dedicated to Fedora is addressed to this wiki. So it's also a wiki that is free for anyone to contribute. It's an open wiki, and we had an issue with that some kind of ago, because someone tried to edit the front page to show advertising and spam. So we try to lock a certain number of page, of web page, and restrict some area of the wiki. So for example, the page that is displaying the GPG key that is that are certified to work with a given Fedora release for the project is log. There is even a translation. Some pages are translated to Spanish, and of course everyone is free to contribute. So when the user installs the release, so they try to probably install manually the release package that are trying to bring up them the project contents, but they are also maybe using a post-installation script, or they are trying to use the project in within the installer, as in they are enabling the repository in Anaconda. I don't know if it's still supported and if it was very well tested. Other method to install the project was probably to use Kickstart and to default the Kickstart installation process. I don't know if it's really used, but maybe it's some kind of process we can try to work to work further, so we can issue the full Kickstart install, so they automatically install the RPM release package, so it's installed by default. I think it's quite interesting to address this issue, because that's, from my understanding, the desktop DIM is trying to think about that that kind of issue, because for certain users it's not that easy to install additional packages, because that doesn't come from source. That's not easy to think about to install additional package every time we need additional package from a community repository. So this is maybe a start for reflection about how we can ease this installation process, because that was also addressed in several mailing lists in the project, that not always, not everyone is fine with having this community repository installed by default in Fedora, and that's fine. We are trying to work with this simple rule that we need to deal with. So of course this prepares an Ansible playbook that can be involved in the process, but that's probably someone else that doing the work, like an admin, like that installing the package for their user, and that's perfectly fine. Maybe we can have a playbook, a different playbook that we can find several. Of course, there is this question that is quite open also, that we might also try to build our own media to build a package by default to the installation media, but that's not something that we would like to do, because it would mean doing a separate QR process, and this is not very, I'm not very fond of that, because that's some kind of redoing the Fedora process and hijacking the Fedora process of the QR. Also we can leave that for downstream user, of not speak about too much about downstream user of the repository, but there's a lot of remix, of Fedora remix, that probably do it the job well for this kind of process.
Okay.
Yeah.
Actually, if we distribute media with RPM Fusion packages on it, don't know if the repo file is okay or not, but imagine you also distribute some RPM Fusion stuff on the media, you can no longer call it Fedora, and you need to rebrand it. And by that, you're basically creating the fork or remix, and such forks and remix already exists. For example, Corora, which yeah. I don't know if it's active yet, I met it a few years ago, but it's basically Fedora with RPM Fusion and something else. So we cannot easily distribute Fedora with RPM Fusion DVDs just like that.
Yes, I think that was my point of view a few times ago, but I think the remix process has changed. Maybe I'm saying something wrong, but I think as soon as there is something like 40% or 50% of the package that come from Fedora, additional package that might come from Fedora, like in a copper repository, or else might be good. I don't know. But yeah, that's kind of the reason why I'm not particularly fond to work with redoing the media the media process. But then let's leave this question open: that how to install the package, the release package for user, because the next step for user to install package is to discover which package they really need from like installing the whole multimedia stack, the streamer and other multimedia application. The way we tried to address this in the previous release was using groups metadata, and this was quite surprising that it works. I think it was Yum feature at that time that when you install a group of package, it will install additional package as soon as the package layout moves. So if you add a package to a groups in Yum, then as soon as you have installed the group, the package will be there as an update automatically. The interesting thing was that if as a repository we are using the same groups, some additional package could be installed, and we could control some kind of additional package that could be installed within the Fedora installation. So it was quite an interesting feature that was introduced in Fedora 20 or maybe later. But I don't know if it still works because that was also surprising to have this behavior, because we try to build the same groups names as Fedora to match the group layout, and it then installed package that was not expected for a given spin. For example, it have installed the GNOME M player, where most users didn't like the idea to have this package installed by default, even if it's related to the GNOME desktop. So that was quite arbitrary package, so we disabled this package, but then it was also probably a security issue, because additional repository could then install a package that a user didn't want by default. So as soon as we don't as the provider of the package. Maybe it was there is some kind of issue with that thing. Another way to install a package was using Fedi or other post installation tools. So it was quite an interesting idea also. But maybe that's something that would need to be handled with package kit, because that's probably what the main tools that are expected to use. So with Fedora 22, there is no support to upstream, but this is the same issue, because we need to install the upstream data to get support to package that are within the project, but are not provided with the official upstream metadata.
Have you talked about this with the upstream developers?
I try to get this idea spread to upstream upstream developer, but I don't know where the.
You might want to talk to Richard Hughes. I don't know.
Yes, Richard.
Maybe he's here. I'm not sure.
No, no, he's not. But Carla Lember is here. We also have been working on software, so he can probably.
Because what I understand, you just add some metadata to the repository, and the GNOME Software Center or whatever it's called should just get it in somehow. I don't know, because I don't use this. I just use the NF Center.
Yeah. But that's probably the way to fix it, is not to have the upstream metadata into a separate package, but into the repository directly. So the idea was to have the upstream application to read the repository and to read the metadata repository. And eventually we could even spread some information where to look at other repository, other third-party repository in this upstream metadata. Because there is some growing interest in RPM Fusion to provide packages that are already in vendor repository, like in Google, Chrome, or I don't know, Skype maybe, or proprietary application. And that, in this case, are not in a repository, but can be installed with a package that can be fetched from the internet. And maybe we can have a way to install, to spread where to look at for this single package in the related section of the repository. Maybe we can say, hey, there is a package that can be installed in this location and spread the metadata as upstream metadata to install this package manually. Even with bootstrapping a GPG key or something. So the other area of the project that users are currently missing is, of course, there's missing support for Rawhide and Branch. So I will talk about the reason why we are a little behind from the infrastructure point of view, and the reason why that's missing. The kernel module package are not rebuilt for Fedora 22, and of course there's also missing features like secure boot support, if that's really missing. Maybe I think it's not the priority of the project for me. There's no Delta RPM support also. We can probably address this issue at a later time, but that's where we are from the user perspective, I think.
Is that the reason why it came out quite a bit on the also?
Is there a reason why?
Is the delta IPM the reason why it came out quite a bit on the field
for? For Fedora 22, the reason is that. Maybe I will talk about this later because the main idea is that we are switching to the new infrastructure and that we are in some kind of in-between state. So because of that, I need to concentrate on other things and to build a new infrastructure. And there is also issue that need to be fixed. So that we can envision to have a script to automatically address this issue in the new infrastructure. So that's why there is an in between state with this feature.
Will the new infrastructure also have a rawhide branch?
It could have a rawhide branch. It could have Fedora 13. Branch also, but it's just a matter of time and to concentrate because actually I finished to work on Fedora 22 just a few days ago, from a few weeks ago, let's say, because the release repository was still moving until that time, and we there is still package to that was failing to build for different reasons, and this takes my time until we try to figure out how to do. But I think we can move over the and start to work on Fedora 23 in early September or later. We probably try to do a mass rebuild. There is no technical issue to do this, but the sooner we fix the new infrastructure, the better the will be done.
Just one thing.
Yeah. Yeah.
The things, and from how you say it, it seems you do this alone. Is it right? Like all the rebuilding and stuff like that, that's you personally and nothing, no one else?
Yeah.
Is there anything we can do to help? Because I think it's very much work, and I could help you if you want.
Yeah. That's. Maybe I can speak about this later, because
okay.
I'm going to speak about the other area. Actually, it's like when you have. You have a headache, or you have something that is bad to you, and you are concentrating on the headache because you have this problem. So my presentation is trying to have a step back and try to see the different features. So that's why I'm trying to speak about the user perspective and. Other contributors' perspective, and try to not to focus on the main issue that is important, but also that there is also other things to consider. So,
just a quick note about the delta RPM from user perspective. I would say
yeah.
You absolutely don't have to care about that.
Exactly.
There is absolutely no use case in the world where delta RPM is faster than normal.
Yeah,
I agree.
Even if it was good, like put it on the very, like the last thing to do. Like
yeah.
It's only good to have maybe even not that.
The only thing why Fedora has delta RPM is because mirrors. Because a Fedora mirror is something like 1.5 terabyte for primary, and another 3 terabytes for secondary. So they really need people of the minimum data to have this. But,
okay.
Last time I checked, the RPM fusion pre and monthly together was something like 150 or 200 gig. And I would say you absolutely don't have to care about that unless
yeah.
The mirrors are complaining.
Yes, that's not the case.
From a user point of view, it's always like the RPM.
Hmm.
Fedora just has it because many of our providers are complaining about.
Okay. Yeah, I think the I completely agree with Delta FM. We can say something else, but it's not that. I think I will go a little bit faster because there's no. So there is a bug zone, the Bugzilla, and that's quite an old instance. It's claimed to build a better one with it's Bugzilla 4.4. This is 4.0. And we are trying to move to another instance that trying to address and enable other features. I don't know if it's XML RPC based, but ABRT, automatic bug report, is trying to build that, use that support from Bugzilla. And it's quite interesting feature to enable. That's user mailing list, and maybe so I'm just going to switch about ABRT because I have an issue previously with VLC, and VLC was complaining that the VLC team, the video LAN team, was complaining that they are not receiving the backtrace from their crash, and they're complaining about the message that was displaying ABRT about that they cannot report this message because it's not packaged from Fedora, and it was trying to say to user to use Fedora package like GStreamer and Totem, and that was totally unacceptable from a video LAN perspective, and they really angry about this, so I try to make them speak with ABRT team directly, and the ABRT team was kind enough to address this issue and to reward the message that was displayed to user about the crash and the inability to report the crash, but we really need to have this reporting because that's needed for open source project that has redistributed from a community repository. So that's another area of upstream relationship that upstream monitoring should be a feature that could be implemented. It is not the case, and it's not done for a reason that should be worked on. There is no mail alias to set up the ABRT to report the feedback. From contributor perspective, so this is packager and plague interface, though we are still using CVS and plague, so that's the main issue of the infrastructure. And we are trying to move to Koji and this Git. So where we are from this point of view is that I'm running currently the RPM Fusion infrastructure from my own Koji instance. And I'm trying to address several issues before it came out to the project, so such build tags, layout, and this is to build separately some kind of the package to make payloads overrides and that kind of things. So we are not. I'm trying to figure out how to fetch some external repository package, like to automatically rebuild the kernel module, for example, from each Fedora 22. And there is a need to figure out how to build a Koji layout to do this, because from my attempt, was not able to submit an override from a package in an external repository. So if you have to deal with Koji, maybe you know the layout, but and the question of the layout, but that's where I am about this issue. So same as a Git preview. This is where are located as the preview Git repository, and some packages are already converted to using Git. All packages from RPL Fusion are already converted to Git, but the Git layout, the Git preview, the Git this Git methods are not already there. So that's an area to set up, and we try to improve a lot in this area. Okay. So the what is missing from the contributor point of view is and Git migration, and there is a need to build to work on the R package and Fed package like tools, and this work hasn't been done. Actually, I've discovered recently that some contributors start working on the subject, but it was not submitted to the mailing list, and we haven't received the feedback on this work. But there is still patches that are coming from contributors, from different people involved in Fedora to have patch merged to Fed package that will ease the work on this kind of tools. So we need to have this Fed package tool that has fronted to R package in ported to RPM Fusion. The same package DB and body was worked on by some user, and unfortunately they never send back to us their experience to set up this tool. So I'm just going to go straight to infrastructure, because so the infrastructure issue is that, as you Nero said, we need to find out a way to delegate right. So maybe you have in mind that I'm trying to coordinate the project, but actually I've only received very recently, like a week ago, I've received the root right to the hypervisor of the project. So I'm not almighty on the infrastructure project, and I cannot delegate the rights as easily as I would like to do. One area of improvement are about infrastructure. I've worked a little bit with this Scaleway, which is a spin-off of Online, which is an ESP host and hosting provider for in France, and they are providing us their sponsored two ARM builders, so the project will be able to have this builder to build a new infrastructure. So other infrastructure are headed by the primary mirror. Mirror manager instance are created by Adrian River, and that's quite easily self-managed. But we can also use GitHub, and I've tried to set up some of the module that have been in preview. So the package that have been modified in Fedora 20 are forwarded to this GitHub RPM Fusion group. But unfortunately, that's not forwarded to the commit mailing list, so it's not public. The updates are not public. We could have also tried to fetch accounts from cloud instance reseller to get builder to for primary architecture, and we could also try to set up in-house Arch builder for secondary architecture. So that's something I tried to set up for ARM some time ago, but now it's available online. So what we are missing from the infrastructure perspective is probably we need more mirror manager instance, because on each release the server are crashing, and they are using a lot of resources and it doesn't scale well. So we need to find a way to build other mirror manager instance that can be done for cloud instance. Also, a good way to delegate and to help others to build the tool is to set up a public Git Ansible playbook, so that we can be work on the main idea of using contributing to the infrastructure is to submit playbook change. So the main area is to the main idea is to pick the Fedora infrastructure Ansible playbook and to convert them to use RPM Fusion, because there's a lot of and that's what is done. Actually, I've done that for some rule of Ansible, like the Koji deployment, and the problem is to convert this to so that it can be reusable by other projects, from Fedora to other projects.
So it's not that easy.
So not that easy. There are.
I was on an infrastructure talk a few hours ago.
Yeah.
Were you there, by Patrick? No.
Yeah.
No.
You
were there. I asked if we want to use this for RPM Fusion, if we can just hit the magic button, and all the playbooks will deploy, and we will have Boji, Koji, Epsilon, and everything. And he said it should work like that.
Yeah, but that's not the case, because there are a lot of
differences.
There's a lot of things that are coded to the Fedora infrastructure. Like every host are coded in the Ansible infrastructure playbook. So there's need to abstract a lot from this playbook from Fedora.
Okay.
I have a lot of patch. I've done this commission for Koji, but the same need to be done for Body and other two. And this Git, the main one is this Git. For example, the script that's creating the Git module for each package is need to be converted for other tools. Okay, so is there any question left?
How can we get involved?
Yes, that's the last line.
Yeah, that's it.
And I have the current state of... I need to figure out the things. The main idea is to... is to probably to start working on the each of the public Git Ansible playbook and try to do the work to convert a given role to abstract the things. The other area is to try to work for a given application and to try to get into the application, to dive into the application and to try to remove everything that is hard-coded to Fedora. I think there is a lot of things that are hard-coded in other applications. So. That's working very well for Mirror Manager because Adrian is actually doing this work. He's actively working with Mirror Manager team and is submitting patch. He's working continuously to not to hard-code things in the Fedora way. But this need to be headed to other application also. So the problem is I cannot do this conversion for every application. I need to collect the work, and I think I will get more involved in trying to set up Ansible in the infrastructure now, and try to fetch, to pull role as soon as they appear, because now I have the ability to create instance and to create, to deploy application more easily, now that I have the right to do this change. So I think that's quite the way to deal with. So to get involved in the process is probably to try to do some work that can be published somewhere and that can be pulled in the dedicated instance, more than trying to delegate the rights, because the problem with delegate server access is that those are private server. They are. I'm not going to drop the name of the one who is paying for the server, but they are probably reluctant to delegate the right to people that they don't know or they don't know well enough or that don't often communicate with the project. So my idea to fix this is really to try to talk with host provider and try to get community server to receive community sponsored host. So that's became a common good. That's what I'm trying to achieve, to fix this issue with dedication of the right to the server, because that's what is that probably try to lock the project. Okay.
Is that page up to date on the contributors page? I just looked at it and I just...
Yes, I think so. I think it's the contributor page for
it's more
packages.
For packages.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's not for what he's talking about.
Yeah.
I'm going to be able to help with what he's doing. I can do packages. Okay.
There is an infrastructure page, but I don't know if it's up to date. I think it's loosely current, but there is much info. There is probably it's probably easier to fetch from different infrastructure, but I think that's not the main area. Is probably to publish some kind of Ansible skeleton that someone can start working on, to figure out how the server are located, and but maybe it's easier to start working with the Fedora ones, the Fedora infrastructure playbook. Okay. Other question? I'm going to stop here. So thank you for your attention. Thank you for being here and trying to support me doing this project. Thank you.